Yes. Quite dead. There's a doornail.
Certificate of death, sir.
Stop! Back away, Praddock.
Dubbins is Dubbins.
From his lordship, the mayor.
Sir.
Be fresh.
short chestnuts. Rice,
how would you like this one, huh?
That's a nice fresh eel.
What we have here is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Get lost.
And under which one is the pea? Boom, 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 boom. Oh, get out of it. Here we are.
I watch this now.
All right, I'll come here.
Merry Christmas, Uncle. God save you.
Bah, humbug.
Christmas humbug? Uncle, you don't mean that.
Merry Christmas. What reason have you to be merry? You're poor enough.
What right have you to be so dismal? You're rich enough.
Humbug!
Don't be cross, Uncle.
What else can I be when I live in such a world of fools as this? Merry Christmas. What's Christmas time to you but a time for paying bills without money? A time for finding yourself a year older and not a penny richer? If I could work my will, every idiot who goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips should be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stake of holly through his heart.
Uncle!
Nephew! Keep Christmas in your own way and let me keep it in mine.
Keep it? But you don't keep it.
Let me leave it alone then. Much good it has ever done you.
There are many things from which I have derived good and have not profited. Christmas being among them. But I've always thought of Christmas as a kind, charitable time. The only time when men open their shut-up hearts and think of all people as fellow travellers to the grave and not some other race of creatures bound on other journeys. And therefore, Uncle, although it has never put a scrap of gold or silver in my pocket, I believe it has done me good, and I say, God bless it!
Let me hear another sound out of you, Cratchit, and you'll keep Christmas by losing your situation. You're quite a powerful speaker, sir. I wonder you don't go into Parliament.
Don't be cross, Uncle. Come, dine with us tomorrow.
I'll see you in hell first.
But why? Why so cold-hearted, Uncle? Why?
Why did you get married?
Because I fell in love.
Because you fell in love. Good afternoon.
I want nothing from you. I ask nothing of you. Why can't we be friends?
Good afternoon.
I'm sorry with all my heart to find you so resolute. But I've made the trial in homage to Christmas, and therefore, Merry Christmas, Uncle!
Good afternoon.
And a Happy New Year.
Good afternoon.
And a very Merry Christmas to you too, Mr. Cratchit. Oh,
Merry Christmas to you, sir.
Another one.
clerk making 15 shillings a week and with a wife and family. Talking about a Merry Christmas. I'll retire to Bedlam.
Ah, good afternoon. A Scrooge and Marley's, I believe. Huh. Ah, have I the pleasure of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Mr. Marley has been dead these 7 years. He died 7 years ago, this very night.
Oh. Well, we have no doubt that his generosity is well represented by his surviving partner. At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is more than usually desirable that we should make some slight provision for the poor and the destitute. Many thousands are in want of common comfort, sir.
Are there no prisons?
Prisons? Yes, plenty of prisons.
And the union workhouses, are they still in operation?
They are. I wish I could say they were not.
The treadmill in full vigor?
Very busy, sir.
Good. I was afraid something had occurred to stop them in their useful course.
Yes, at this festive season, a few of us are endeavoring to raise a fund to buy the poor some meat and drink and means of warmth. What shall we put you down for?
Nothing.
Oh, you wish to remain anonymous?
I wish to be left alone. I don't make merry myself at Christmas, and I can't afford to make idle people merry. I support the establishments I have mentioned. And those who are badly off must go there.
Many cannot go there. And, well, frankly, many would rather die.
Then they had better do it and decrease the surplus population. Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon.
You'll want all day tomorrow, I suppose.
Well, quite convenient, sir.
It's not convenient, and it's not fair. If I were to dock you a half a crown for it, you'd think yourself ill-used. And yet you don't think me ill-used when I pay a day's wages for no work.
Well, it's only once a year, sir.
Poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December. But I suppose you must have the whole day. Be here all the earlier the next morning.
Sir.
Ha ha ha!